Johan Manas may have taken the long and winding route towards becoming a global designer, but he has been making resounding waves in the fashion scene since his debut in 2012. After getting accepted as the first Filipino student at Bantan Design Institute in Shibuya, Tokyo, one of Japan's top fashion design schools, he has built and grown his menswear brand, J-Man, from the ground up under the mentorship of his five senseis. Before becoming a designer, he has taken some detours that shaped who he is, among them being a pre-med student in the Philippines and being a fashion and advertising photography student at the New York School of Visual Arts, where he stumbled upon, or better yet, raced toward fashion while running the 2010 Tokyo Marathon. Get to know more about Tokyo-based designer Johan Manas. I'm now with Johan here at Bunbuku, a casual izakaya pub-style restaurant in Tokyo. It used to be a sento or a bathhouse, serving the local community for 90 years until its owners eventually converted it into a restaurant. Since then, it has been making headlines around Japan. Hi guys, so I'm waiting for Johan right now, and this is a really interesting place because it used to be a bathhouse and now they turned it into a restaurant. So medyo quiet lang ako because I don't want to disturb other people, but I think he's here.
Wow. Hello. That looks good.
Kain na. Johan, thank you so much for taking the time to have lunch with me and touring me around here in Tokyo today. So for now, let's eat.
Let's do this. You know how it's done in Japan, you say, before you eat, itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu?
Yeah.
Itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu.
Itadakimasu. Thank you, Johan. That was a great lunch in an interesting location. Thank you.
I'm happy to hear this. I'm so glad you liked it. So now I'm going to take you to Desperado. I'll show you more of the designs and what J-Man is all about.
It's J-Man time. Yeah. In a fast-moving fashion mecca like Tokyo, street style is always next level. Yet I noticed that there are so many fashion styles, cultures, and subcultures that it would be challenging even for the most dedicated fashion freak to keep up. Moving around the city, you will be amazed by some of the most authentic, imaginative, and inspiring fashion styles you'll ever see. But make no mistake, because these outfits are motivated by self-expression and not just by the rules of style. Just look at how seriously the Japanese take their fashion here. I love how everything's functional, yet designed to delight and surprise at the same time. Of course, carving his own mark right here at the heart of Tokyo streetwear fashion is Johan Manas of J-Man.
Here at Desperado, we have a pop-up exhibition for the current spring-summer collection and the upcoming autumn-winter collection. Here it is!
Ooh, we're here!
Desperado!
One of the best things in meeting Johan in Tokyo is having the chance to visit the Desperado store where his collections are proudly sold. You can see through the designs how Desperado takes pride in presenting a wide range of designs that contributes to Tokyo street fashion.
Yes, we're finally here inside Desperado Tokyo. Mm-hmm. This is a multi-brand store, a select store, not just for mainstream brands, but independent brands as well. Independent designers. So it's a mixture of everything, from clothes to hats, bags, accessories, name it, they have it. And these are hand-picked. So like this, see, from something dark to something really colorful. So you won't find the typical or trendy fashions here. It's usually like aggressive one. And sometimes other stores don't carry it because it's exclusive for this store.
I need time to look around.
Yes.
And this is yours.
And yes, finally we're here at the pop-up of J-Man at Desperado.
How does it feel to have your brand included
in the store.
Like, oh, this. Definitely, how do you say it? Flattering. Beyond flattering, beyond compliment. If I'm allowed to say, an achievement on its own.
Oh, yes, definitely.
It's a dream come true. Not just to be in Japan, but to be in Tokyo, to be in a store like this.
How would you describe your style?
Maybe it's weird, it's not for everyone. It's neither good, neither bad that it's not for everyone, but I'd say it's uniquely J-Man. Whether you like it or you don't like it, it's originally J-Man.
I like that.
First impression of Pia, that she's very low-key. I mean, despite her stature, of course she's very beautiful, but she's really, really simple. At first, you know, we were trying to get to know each other, but then eventually, when we became comfortable with each other, I enjoyed.
Okay, so how did it all begin first? So, before you became J-Man as the shoemaker we know today?
I was a pre-med student, a 20s teenager who was lost, found my way through design. Tokyo gave me the freedom. Tokyo liberated me. Tokyo allowed me to be myself. Tokyo gave me a fresh start. Gave me a clean palette, and Tokyo allowed me to use J-Man as my medium for creativity. You know, that started from clothing, and then now I'm specializing and focusing in shoes.
I think that's very inspirational, because a lot of people who are watching this are probably right now in the same position as you were years ago, where they're like, they're studying, but they're not sure if that's really the course they want to do. Yeah. It's not their passion. Like you, I took up culinary before, but I don't really practice it professionally anymore.
But although, you cook wearing your sash?
No, wala pa na akong sash nun eh.
Okay.
So you wouldn't think, diba, like from culinary, you'll go into pageants, and you from pre-med into shoemaking here in Japan. Like, who would have thought?
Nobody.
Sometimes you feel like you're lost, but in the end, you'll realize na, ah, kaya pala things didn't work out for me at that time, because this is what's really meant for me. That's kind of like your story. Honestly.
That is my story.
And that's why you're the man, J-Man. <Just kidding. laughs> So, Johan, can you take us back? How did you decide to move to Tokyo?
Oh, Pia, that's a very long story. Let's have a coffee break first.
Excuse me as I grab a quick coffee break before we talk more about how Johan established J-Man here in Tokyo. I just got to try these cute vending machines here. Stay tuned for more.